In this tutorial, I'm going to review the bitmap mode in the Place Rhinestones Docker. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go over to the Macros Docker. I'm going to select Place Rhinestones. And then we're going to pick our settings. Now in the drop-down mode, what we're going to do is we're going to select bitmap mode. And what this is going to do, it's going to take an image that's a photograph or a bitmap, and it's going to convert it into a rhinestone pattern. And it's going to convert that pattern based on a grid layout. So you'll get to see what it looks like. It's very similar to a rasterized fill. Now the other thing you can do with this feature is you can actually take vector graphics and convert those to that same rasterized fill with different colors as well. So let me kind of show you the different settings, and we'll walk through a sample project. I'm going to go ahead and import an image. This happens to be a TIFF image. Generally it's best if you have an image that's isolated from the background. So what I did with this image first is I had a background on there. I took it into Corel Photo Paint. I used the cutout lab to cut around the background. So there was an actual forest background here, and I just cut out the background. So these are the kind of images that work the very best, is when you cut out the background. Now what I'm going to do next is I'm just going to go ahead and apply some settings. First of all, a couple ground rules. The bigger the image, the better. It'll be able to carry more detail. Also, the smaller the stones, the better. These look terrific in SS6s. You want to try to keep them between 4 and 6 color layers. Anything below 3 color layers, you have a tendency to lose some of the contrast to produce the effect, but 4, 5, and 6 is pretty ideal. Also, we're going to go ahead and size this up. I'm going to make this 10.5 inches tall, so I'll just type in 10.5 on the property bar. There we go, we've got it sized up. And let's go ahead and create a bitmap. So what we're going to do, I'm going to go down to settings, bitmap mode, object distance right here, that's the distance between stones. So the bigger that number, the fewer the stones in the count, because there's more spacing. And normally I start out with 1 millimeter. Now if I check use object color, so we're going to go ahead and check use object color. What this feature is going to do, it's going to use all the colors in the graphic. Well, this is a photograph. It's got thousands of different colors in it. So here's what's going to happen. If I use that setting, I'm going to go ahead and check background mask so we can don't have to trace over the original white background, because there's a white bounding box around here. So let's change our background color here to black so you can see that. So we're just going to select use object color, background mask. Click on execute. And it's going to do the conversion. Pretty awesome. Let's go ahead and zoom in on this so you can see the effect. Pretty amazing effect, isn't it? Now here's the problem. If you go over to layers, you're going to have probably 100 colors in there. Also, you'll notice our stone size is too big, so it's creating a lot of crowding. So let's take that same design and we'll go ahead and undo that. And then what we're going to do is we're going to go over to macros. And we're going to use a different setting. We're going to say set object size. We're going to go ahead and select 2.4 millimeters right there. Our spacing is going to be 1 millimeter. Click on execute. There we go. Definitely a better look there. Again, same problem. We've got hundreds of colors. So how do you eliminate that? Well, the way you can eliminate that is by using an object list. So let me show you how that would work. Instead of selecting use object color, I'm going to uncheck set object size. I'm going to set the object size and the color from an object list. So we'll go down here and we'll uncheck that. There's preset object lists. So if I check use object lists, there's a preset object list. Now one thing that's very important, if you want to update the object list based on, you know, what's selected in your graphic, you can actually create your own stone library from what's selected. And the way you would do that, you'd have to check use object color, and then you can have the option of updating object list. This is something I generally don't recommend, because what you're going to be doing is you're going to be adding objects to an existing object list. And so it's generally a lot easier just to uncheck this option and just use an existing object list and not update the list. So that's a preference that I have. So here's some preset lists. If we want to add another preset list, we can go over here to Edit Rhinestone Library, this little button over here. Very important. We can go ahead and select a different library. So let's select a different library, and we'll use a library that's based on, we could say, 4-color SS10 stones. So there's our library. And we can change these colors and diameters and all that, and we can save all kinds of different libraries. Now here's the thing. It's not important to choose colors that are the finished colors in your design. You can go back and change the colors later. The main thing is the sizes of the rhinestones as well as the number of colors, and that there's a good contrast between them. So we'll go ahead and click on Save. And that's going to be in my drop-down list now. Here's some other presets. In this case, you know what we'll do? We'll use SS6, 6 color. We'll do this in a 6 color. So that's going to be the preset. And that's kind of my tolerance for the number of layers here. So we're going to mask out the background. We're going to use the object list. Here's our spacing. We're in bitmap mode. Click on execute. And there we go. So let's take a look and see how many stones we have in this. If we select it, right down here we have 3321 stones. And here's where we can do some stone reduction. And also we can go ahead and reassign the color. So let's zoom in here. I'm just going to grab my zoom tool and we're going to zoom in here pretty tight. And I'm going to go and change the colors now. So one thing I could do is this red area. I could use the garment color if this is going to go on black. I could use the garment color instead of that area. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select the red layer right here, which is light cyan. This was pulled from my object list. We'll select it. Click on SEL to select all those and delete that layer. Or I can just turn it off. Actually, I'll just right mouse click and I'll turn that layer off. So I'll say not visible. So now we've got the garment color coming through. Next thing we can do is we can compare this to the original image and we can say, hey, what do we want? For the darker gray, I think we're going to use the green. It's going to be a darker gray, so I'll hit select and we'll make that kind of a charcoal gray there. And then the purple is going to be a lighter gray. So we'll go down here and click on the amethyst layer, hit select, and we'll do a lighter gray. And let's see, it looks like we have one other color here. We can scroll through here. It looks like we have a crystal color, which is, yeah, that's good. I think we're going to leave that alone. So we have different color layers here. We've set this design up. It's now a 6-color design. I could combine some colors just by selecting the colors. Let's say I wanted to combine this jet hematite color here with the crystal. We could do that. So there's a lot of flexibility in terms of creating these patterns. I can go ahead and hit Control Z to undo any changes and start experimenting. Now, if you're going to produce a design like this, it's critical that you use the transfer application system. So what you would be doing is setting up different layers and different stencils for each color in the design, and then you'd use the transfer application system smart frames to create all the alignments. And you can create some really exciting designs. This particular design, you know, let's take a look at the stone count just by selecting it. This particular design, you have 3,321 stones. For a design that's this detailed, it's really not that many stones. I think the really good sweet spot for creating designs with this photorealistic effect is, you know, around 10 inches by 10 inches, right in that 3,000 stone range. You know, I could go in here too if I wanted to delete a color layer, combine a color layer. I could have more of the garment color showing through as well. So that gives you a pretty good idea of what you can do with the photograph. But let me show you something that you can do with a vector image. So we'll do the same exact concept. So I'm going to go ahead and close this document. We're going to open up a new document. And this particular document is a vector image. And I took this image from one of our clip art volumes. This image actually came from a volume called Ready Art Volume 1. If we take a close look at the image, you'll notice that there's some nice little shading that's been built into it. You've got three or four colors. The image is vector-based, so if I hit F9 on my keyboard, you can see that. But I can use that same bitmap mode on the top of a vector graphic as well. The key is having good contrast between the colors. Now, if I wanted to create more contrast, what I could do is I could convert this image to a bitmap. And probably going to use a 24-bit. We can actually take that down to 8-bit. That'll reduce my colors a little bit. And then we've converted that to a bitmap. So if you have an image that has you know, quite a few colors, you can use the posterization filter. If you want, you go over here and type in a value, let's say 2, and you can reduce the colors that way using the posterization filter. That really is only going to work on a bitmap graphic. So let's go ahead and undo all this. Control Z. Control Z, see if we can get back to our original vector graphic. There we go. I don't have to convert this. The only reason I'm showing you converting it to the bitmap is it gives you a little bit more flexibility in terms of using the posterization feature to reduce colors. So next thing we're going to do here is we're going to resize it. Again, I'm going to go over here and type in 10. We're going to make this about 10 inches. And I'll hit F4 on my keyboard so we can zoom to page. And we're going to go over here to the macros docker and bitmap mode. Now I'm going to use a different setting. Because I have a very clear distinction between the colors and the graphic, I don't have to use an object list here. What I could do is uncheck that and just say use object color. say set object size. So we can go ahead and set that as 2.4 millimeters by 2.4 millimeters. I'm going to mask out the background. Very important is to not check anti-aliasing. What anti-aliasing will do is if there's two colors immediately adjacent to each other, it'll blend them in. And that can create extra colors in your image. And it also can create extra colors when you convert this into a rhinestone pattern. So generally speaking, the anti-aliasing function should be turned off. So let's go ahead and convert this. I'll click on execute. It's going to convert that into a pattern. And we'll move that over to the side here, and we'll change the color. We'll change the background color on here so we can see what's going on. So we'll go down here, click on Edit Working Area, and I'll make that blue so it really stands out. There you go. So that design right there, pretty awesome. You've got, you know, the red teeth, you've got the red tongue, you've got the white teeth, you've got the accent colors around the face, even the little, if we zoom in here, you even have the different shades here of gray. You might want to go in. You can delete some of these white layers over here, although that creates some nice contrast, so I might leave that in there. If you have a stone, you can go and move these stones around, add stones, delete stones. But generally speaking, it turns out pretty well. Now let's go ahead and take a look at our color layers and see what we've got here. Guess what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So again, if we wanted to, we could delete that black layer just by going over here, selecting it, hitting SEL, hit delete. So now we've got the color coming through. We could combine a couple colors. We could take, you know, a light gray and a dark gray and combine those two together, and we can create a very dynamic effect. And this design really don't have that many circles here. Let's see. 1885. This is a great effect for doing mascots. Also works really well for doing custom logos. The whole thing about this feature is you have to play. You have to go in, experiment with the settings, try different values, try different colors, try different stone counts. You can mix sizes and colors from the object list. Some of the object lists have a combination of SS6s and SS10s. And so you can create some very dynamic effects. I promise you, the very first time you output one of these and create a heat transfer, you're going to get really excited about it. And the only person that's going to be more excited about it is your customer. You put one of these in front of your customer, and they're just going to place an order. It's absolutely a wonderful feature. So that concludes this tutorial lesson.